Hello friends, welcome back to your channel Simplify Your Space. This video is on utility area organization. Utility area is the place where we keep our washing machine or wash utensils. It is mostly at the back of the bathroom or kitchen. But as this area is always hidden, it is sometimes ignored or is used as a dumping zone. It has happened with me as well, but the aim was to always have an organized and functional utility area. In this video, I am going to show you the organization and tips which may help you to design or renovate your utility area. So let's get started. So this is our utility area which has an entrance from our kitchen. The back wall has all the storage cabinets including loft and the counter space. This side we have the kitchen sink where we wash our utensils. We also have one bathroom here. Now let's start from here. This is the place for washing machine. We have made this enclosed cabinet for a front load washing machine to keep it protected from dust. Also, the whole area looks neat and concealed. Next to this is a pull out cabinet to store dirty clothes for laundry. Generally, this basket is used for storing dirty linen only, and dirty clothes are stored in a bathroom itself. Next to it is this deep storage cabinet where on the top shelf I store all the cleaning supplies. Like in this basket, I store all the open and running laundry and cleaning supplies, and in this basket all the extra monthly stock. Middle basket is utilized to store all the extra stock of cleaning tools such as garbage bags, cleaning wipes, sponges and scrubs to wash utensils. I recently got to know about this Exo Bacto Scrub. A month back, I watched a video on YouTube about this product and found it interesting. And then few days later, I received this product from the brand to try. And believe me, it's really nice and useful. It has an antibacterial coating, Bactogard, which prevents bacteria from breeding onto the scrubber. It has 94.2 less malodour when compared with other scrubbers. So it does not smell bad after washing the utensils, and since Exo Bacto Scrub has an antibacterial coating, that is Bactogard, which makes it good and safe choice for our kitchen. As these cabinets are deep, I use baskets to keep all the supplies to make it convenient for me. In the lower shelf, this basket is used for storing daily newspaper. Our vacuum cleaner is also stored here with all its attachments. Above is this granite countertop. On the corner here, these two baskets are kept for dirty cleaning clothes and kitchen towels. To decorate this place, I have placed this beautiful money plant here along with this DIY chalkboard, which I made it from an old chopping board which I don't use anymore. I have just spray painted it and then used regular chalks to make this wall sign. Just by adding few simple decoration items, the whole look changes. Now moving on to the other corner. Here, the steel dishwashing rack is kept. Once the dishes are washed, I keep them here to air dry. I have also placed a mat underneath to protect the counter from the water dripping from the dishes. Now let's check out the top storage. Here on the lower shelf, I have stored few spray paints in the corner. Then this gardening tool caddy. This is very convenient if I have to carry tools to my balcony for gardening. Next is this tool kit with all the screwdrivers, pliers, etc. Small accessories are kept separately in the small box so that they are easy to access. Same way, I have kept different types of screws and nails separately in this small box. To utilize vertical space, this over the cabinet rack is placed to store extra wire extensions. On the top, mostly all the festive decorations and items are kept. Like here in this box, all the Diwali torans and various types of fairy lights are stored. This way they stay dust free and can be easily accessed whenever needed. In this box, I have stored all the used diyas to repaint and reuse them next year. In these small boxes, few other items are kept such as tea light candles, rangoli colors and holy colors. And in this basket, some random miscellaneous stuff is kept which is hard to be categorized,
like cloth clips, gasket, command hooks, extra measuring cup, etc. Purpose of showing you all this is that if you store and take care of your items well, you can always reuse them for the years and save money on buying new ones. On the doors, I have placed my laundry schedule and stain removal guide, which you must have seen in my laundry routine video. Let's move to the second cabinet. In this lower shelf, I have stored some of these empty cardboard boxes which we get from online shopping. Next to it, in this basket, few disposable items are kept, like plates, glasses, some packing boxes, etc. On the top shelf, few of my extra organizers are kept, which I am not using currently. Now in this cabinet, the lower shelf is utilized to store all the cleaning and dusting clothes, as well as these laundry bags for laundry and delicate clothes. On the top shelf, these microfiber dusters are kept along with few extra shelf liners and extra pack of kitchen towels. On the door space, I have hung two pairs of cleaning gloves with the help of binder clip and command hook. Now in this utility area, we have locked storage also, which is utilized to store mainly puja and havan related stuff and extra disposable crockery and cutlery. On this corner here, I have placed a wall mounted clothes hanging hook to hang all the cleaning tools like brushes, mops, wipers and plastic broom. This way they stay organized and look presentable. Also accessing them is very easy when needed. I have not placed a regular broom here as it does not have any hanging option, so I keep it under the cabinet. But one can use this type of broom gripper which can easily hold regular broom. I have used it previously, but in this house I preferred this one. On the side here, the dustbin is kept for dry waste. Now let's see the sink area. This is the sink where we wash our utensils, not the round sink which is inside the kitchen. On the corner here is this holder to organize the cleaning brushes and scrub pads. I've also kept this sink corner tray, which you would have seen before, to place dish liquid and hand wash. Above the sink is this cabinet, which is actually a plate drying rack. While washing, we keep placing all the plates here, which makes the dishwashing process more organized. It also has a dripping tray which collects all the dripping water. Once the plates are dry, I place them back in the kitchen. Under the sink is another cabinet. The door space is utilized to store the dustbin for wet waste, which is very convenient to use while washing utensils. Inside, I've just stored running dishwashing liquid and floor cleaner. Also, I've kept this container to collect waste scrub pads, which I use to clean dustbins. Next is this door, which is the extension of this area. Here on the door, I have placed this steel rack and utilized it to store garbage bags. Next cabinet is for gas cylinders. Nothing else can be kept here. I have placed the cylinders on these wall stands for easy movement of cylinders and avoid damage to both the floor and cylinders. As I do not have enough space inside the lower cabinet to store dirty dishes, I have kept this container with lid on the countertop. I store all the dirty dishes after dinner in this container so that sink stays empty, which really looks bad when it is full of dishes. Also, by keeping them in the container with lid, no pest can reach them, which makes the kitchen safe from the cockroaches. This is my preferred way, but you can always opt for whatever is convenient and suits you. Now here is another cabinet where we have placed a water purifier. I've also placed a rack here as I had one but not utilizing it for anything yet. Next to it is this poly bag organizer, which is a very good way to store all small bags which are hard to organize. Also, removing any bag is very easy when required. Below is the place where I store a stool, a bucket to carry wash clothes and mop bucket. Last but not the least, on utility door, I have placed this cloth hanging hook to organize all the cloth shopping bags.
Those of you who don't have a separate utility area or don't have cabinets in utility area can get some ideas to organize their cleaning and laundry supplies from our laundry routine video or under the sink cabinet organization video. In these videos, we have shared some renter-friendly ideas to organize laundry and cleaning supplies. The link is provided in the description box of this video. Thank you for watching. Please give a thumbs up if you like this video and don't forget to subscribe for many more organizing videos. I'll see you next week. Happy organizing from Simplify Your Space. Bye-bye.